Welcome to a special edition. Nah, it's not really even special editions anymore.
Oh, I dude it.
I was thinking, like, is this really a special edition anymore? It's pretty much our show.
All right.
Welcome to
Dude.
Check this out.
Check us out.
So today we're gonna react to a new band that I haven't heard yet. It comes by a suggestion from one of our subscribers named Ann.
Hi, Ann.
Hey, Ann. The band is called The 1975. Like the year, 1975. And the song is called The Sound. So, yeah, never heard of these guys. Well, I've heard of the band just because, you know, the suggestions, and I've seen the name of the band scrolling through some YouTube stuff, but haven't watched any of them.
All right. I'm completely aware of the fact that my camera is... Get over here, you stupid camera. Don't play with that. Oh, what is that?
It's glitching.
Is that... That's work, AJ. Work, AJ looks terrible. There we go. How's that? Maybe it'll stop glitching. Sorry about that, everybody. All right, so 1975. Let me share screen. All right, here we go. Cool lighting. Let's go. So, what do you think so far?
It sounds like late 80s, early 90s pop, all like if you mixed every genre and meld them together into one song. It kind of had a lot. I was trying to figure out the song, but I was like, it kind of sounds like a Prince beat in the background.
Yeah.
Is that what you're going for?
I wrote down Prince ? Like, there's a lot of, I mean, clearly I think we were hypnotized by the purple at the beginning of this.
Yeah. But, almost like a Raspberry Beret-ish sound. But they're playing their own instruments.
Yeah. I mean, credit.
Much I love credit it.
There you go. All right. Let's keep going here. Yeah.
Reciprocation is your style about me. Sycophantic, prophetic, Socratic, junkie wannabe. And there's so much skin to see. It's simple Epicurean philosophy. Oh, when you say I'm such a cliche, oh, I can't see the difference in it even way. And we left things to protect my mental health, but you call me when you're bored and you're playing with yourself. You so conceited, I said I don't love you. What does it matter if I lie to you? I don't regret it, but I'm glad we're with you. So don't you tell me that you just don't get it, 'cause I know you. And I know we know.
So I wrote down two more bands.
Yeah. What do they sound like?
Kind of like Wham Culture Club-ish meets New Kids on the Block. Or that early boy band stuff. As far as the vocals and the repetition of the hook.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm kind of like focused on the fact, like when you said Backstreet Boys, like there's no dancing. These guys are not dancing because, like you said, they're playing their instruments, right? They're
And I'm trying to tell if that's a actual bass line or if that's keyboard generated bass line. Mm-hmm. It almost has a like that 80s keyboard generated bass line.
There's like this string in the chorus. There's this string quarter note playing over.
Yeah.
And it's like it's buried a little bit in the mix, but when he stops singing because he's taking a breath in between lines, like you hear the strings. You're like, bing, bing, bing. I'm sorry. It's like,
is that you? I know.
The band. Ding, ding, ding.
Yep. It's like playing the triangle in the corner.
Something that happens in the studio. Yeah, exactly. Something you hear faintly in the studio, you'd never hear it live, right?
Right.
Shall we continue?
Yeah.
Let us wrap this one up here.
That was the New Kids on the Block sound of the doom doom doom. That reminded me of total late 80s, early 90s boy band.
Yeah. Is this that's it. Alright, it ended. Let me stop sharing here.
I think I kinda appreciate that they were flashing up words that probably what some of their critics have described them as. Contrived, repetitive,
wannabes.
Yeah. And I think the guitar solo, the octave pedal guitar solo, saved it a little bit. I kind of like that on that Mustang, or not Mustang, the Jaguar or Jazzmaster.
Yeah. I mean, it was a pop song with a guitar solo. Like, if you didn't like it, for me, that saved it, right? There was, but that and they're playing their instruments. I mean, it's got the DNA of a Prince pop song, upbeat tempo, a catchy chorus. I could see, you know, bopping down the road going, okay, I don't have to turn that off. I don't hate it, but now it's going to be in my head like an earworm forever. I'm going to have to drink some scotch to get rid of it.
Yeah. But the repetition of a boy band, you know, where they don't have anything real deep to talk about, so they find a hook and run with it.
Yeah. And then it's stuck in your head until you drink a lot of scotch to
get it. I don't know exactly what they're saying, but you got da 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 da. It's so that's got its hooks into you.
Yep. Then beep beep beep. Yeah. Like, psycho. Like that's what it is. It's the psycho. The shower scene.
Yeah.
You know, like, gee, gee,
gee. Yeah.
All right. Well, 1975. I'm not going to like throw them in the garbage. I would like to check out another one. I won't get there.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Listen to them. Maybe another session we'll sit down and we'll cover another song from the 1975.
Yeah, if anybody out there has a better suggestion of another one of their songs, for sure I would like to check them out. Any band that plays their own instruments, I'll give a second chance. I mean,
so thanks, Ann, for recommending the 1975.
The 1975. It can't have anything to do with the year they were born because they're way too young for that.
It's probably when their parents were born, maybe.
Maybe. So, yeah, let us know if anybody knows what the significance of the name of their band, the 1975, is.
Oh, yeah. Let's find that out. So,
yeah, that'd be cool.
All right. Want to close it up, Dave?
Yep. Check us out on all of the other social networks. Comment, like, subscribe below, click. You know, we'll probably have another video up in one of these corners, one that you can click on and check out some of our other stuff. And thanks for watching.
See you, everybody.
See ya.